Views and opinions expressed on Marty's Corner do not reflect those of this cable station, any city cable board, its management, or staff. In fact, they do not reflect my opinion or the opinion of anyone I know. They do not reflect the opinion of the People's Republic of China or the people in the land down under we call Australia. Some of the views and opinions don't even reflect the opinion of Marty. They're just abstract little things that he says to fill time without really thinking about it. The only person with sole responsibility for content on this program is the producer, who, if anything should go wrong or be deemed generally offensive or out of line, will be made to pay dearly. And now sit back and enjoy Marty's Corner.
Live from Austin Heights, it's Marty's Corner! With your host, Marty Shields! And DJ Leonardo Flores! I'm your announcer, Tony Ridley. On tonight's show, Hacienda Heights resident and former Romper Room host, Marianne King. Comedian and TV host, Tom Riehl. Musician, Tabitha Greenlees. And rock band, Truly Lover Trio. And now, all he wants for Christmas is his two front teeth. Here's Marty!
Take two. Welcome to Marty's Corner. We come to you live, as always, from Channel 3 in, here in Hacienda Heights. How are you all doing tonight? Come on, get loud. One time, come on. Now, normally at the beginning of the show, I go ahead and do a little monologue, say some funny things that are going on in the world. And I'm just not feeling it tonight. I want to talk about something a little more important that has been on my mind for a while, and that's, of course, the station here at Channel 3. Those of you who watch Marty's Corner and also watch Channel 3 at a regular basis might not be aware of the fact that the funding for the station has been cut. And so as it stands now, we might have a few short months left before the station goes black. Now, of course, here at Marty's Corner, we love the station, we love the channels, and we want to make sure that all of you that are out there get behind us in our attempt to save this station. We're looking for individuals who are like-minded like us, who want to save the station. And I want to make sure that it's clear to everyone that's watching that we don't want to go ahead and blame anyone. We don't want to go and point fingers. We want to make sure that things get done from this point on and that we do all we can do to save the station. That's my personal commitment to you that have been watching my show for 13 years. I do ask that all the producers that that do shows here at Channel 3, and that, of course, is the producer and host of Deliver Us From Evil, Winston Smith, the producer and host of the Mr. Duran Show, Richard Duran, and our good friend Jack Rodriguez, the producer of Touched by the Master, hear this, and I want them to know that this is an open invite from me, Marty Shields, to you to get together and talk about what we can do to save this station. So again, we want all of you to know that we are behind Channel 3, and we feel that this station is a very important part of this community. It has been for over 20 years. So again, we want to let you know that as of this point on, Marty's Corner will keep broadcasting as long as we can, if we can get the support from the community and the people that are watching the station to keep this going. So again, thank you very much. We do have a good show for you here on Marty's Corner, our 113th show here live on Channel 3. We have a lady who's a great friend of Marty's Corner. She's been to the show several times. She's a resident here in Hacienda Heights. Of course, a lot of you know her growing up in the Southern California area, a living legend, and she'll be on to talk a little bit with us tonight. Marianne King is here tonight. Marianne King live on the show. A gentleman joins us for maybe the third time he's been on our show, and just a very funny man. Along with being a stand-up comedian, he's also the host of a very cool and hip food show that's seen in public access television. And he'll be on not only to talk a little bit about that, but also do some cooking for us during the holiday season. Tom Riehl is here tonight. Tom Riehl live on the show. Big Tom. We have a young lady who has spent the last 4 years in London perfecting her craft. She's an incredible musician, and she's been nice enough to come on the show, and she's going to be doing some incredible Christmas songs for us here. Tabitha Greenlees is here tonight on the show. Tabitha! And last but not least, three gentlemen come down that are going to be playing some rock and roll music for you tonight. Truly Lover Trio is here tonight on the show. Live. And of course, I couldn't do the show without him. As always, to my left, the one, the only, Leonardo Flores. Leo. I just knocked my water bottle over. I'm probably flooding the studio. Welcome back. As you know here in the studio audience, one of the members of our crew hasn't been with us for a while. This gentleman has been gone for maybe 6 months. And of course, those of you in the studio know that he's kind of a take charge kind of guy. We refer to him lovingly as a Nazi. Because he's so out of his mind. Of course, he keeps me on track and makes sure that the timing is right on the show. And of course, we wanted to make sure that we welcomed him back the only way Marty's Corner knows how, by doing a top 11 list on Marty's Corner. So our top 11 list that we haven't done in probably some time is dedicated to our good friend Tony Ridley. So if we could, let's go ahead and bring that up in the control room. There's Tony. Top 11 reasons why the crew isn't happy Tony's back. So let's go ahead. Number 11. Number 11 on the list is number 11. Sound engineer Wally is ticked off that Tony always is challenging him to a pose off. Maybe not. Number 10. He appeared drunk on The View. Number 9. Has stage manager Mandy polish his nipple rings during commercial breaks?
Who wouldn't?
Yeah. Number 8. Thought we took care of him in a bunker in 1945. Wow. Number 7, he steals pens. Number 6, demands Marty use his influence to restore order to Iraq. Number 5, bands are complaining about his insistence of body cavity searches.
Wow.
Number 4, station manager Tim hates Tony's potty mouth and pushy manner. Number 3, complains DJ Leo doesn't play enough Air Supply. Number 2, Tony's endearing gaze makes camera operator Julian skittish. And the number 1 reason why the crew isn't happy Tony is back, he poisoned an ex-KGB spy. Thank you. Welcome back, Tony. Happy Merry Christmas. Of course, Christmas time is here in the Southland, and every year I go out and buy a Christmas tree. And of course, this year is like no other. I always have a live Christmas tree and a green Christmas tree in my house. And thank you, Wally. And what we're going to do today is we took a camera crew out to a local tree lot in the area, and we talked to some of the folks that work down at the local Tahoe Christmas tree here in San Gabriel Valley. Could you roll that B-roll in the control room and watch your monitors and your viewers at home? Go right ahead. Take it away.
Many long years have passed since the day when we walked o'er the meadows along by the bay. The moon shone so brightly and stars we could see. On our way home with our first Christmas tree.
It's Christmas time, of course, here in Hacienda Heights, and we're at one of the largest tree lots here in the area, the Tahoe Christmas Tree Lot. We're speaking with Betty, one of the, are you a manager? What's your official title, Betty?
Office manager.
Office manager. And what is your job entail? What do you do?
I set up all the manager lots, all the paperwork, the credit card machines. I get the registers, payroll, all that.
Everything, pretty much. And do you sweep up also, or does somebody else sweep up?
Other people sweep up, but I do that too if I have to.
Now, you said lots. How many lots do you have?
5, including this one's 5.
Well, whereabouts? I mean, obviously the one
Pasadena,
here.
Pasadena, Upland, Monterey Park, Highland Park, and Upland, Up Pasadena, Upland, Highland Park, Monterey Park, and here.
Christmas tree. Little we knew, sometimes we'd be sad. Thank God we remember the good times we had. And each year at Christmas we'll walk by the sea.
Where the hell am I?
On our way home with our first Christmas tree.
Yeah, tell us about this tree lot. You got all different kind of trees, big ones, small ones. What are the most popular trees that you find so far?
The most popular trees I find are nobles.
Nobles?
Nobles, yeah.
Why are people buying nobles?
Better quality tree.
They last longer. Does it hold up well?
They live longer. Yeah, they're fresher. Plantations, they hold up, but these have a higher standard.
What's this area right here we're looking at?
This is the plantation auction area.
And what happens there exactly?
Basically, the customers walk up to you, ask you, they show me a 5, 6, 6, 7, 7, 8.
Yeah.
You show it to them, open it up, cut the string, slam it down, it opens the tree up. Basically, it's an auction area, so if another customer's looking at it and someone else standing next to it,
they're bidding on it, basically.
Yes.
Do you do this also, or certainly only certain people?
Of course, yeah.
Can you do one for us real quick, so we can see a little bit?
What size would you like to see, sir?
Let's see a 6, 7. And how much is this tree going to cost about?
$34.95
plus tax or whatever.
Plus tax, and if you'd like to stand, yeah, an extra $4.
Wow. We appreciate it, George. Where's the bathroom around here?
The bathroom's
back here. Bathroom on the backside? Thank you, George. Appreciate it, man. Thank you.
Some things I've forgotten, and the things I can't see. But I'll always remember our first Christmas tree.
We'd like to thank all the people here at the Tahoe Christmas Tree Lot for letting us come down. And again, have a happy and merry Christmas from Marty's Corner. Take care. God bless. Happy New Year. We want to thank all the folks over at all the folks at the Tahoe Christmas Tree Lot for letting us come down. We need to go away for a quick 3-minute break. We'll be right back. Don't go away. Leo, play us out. Let's go!
I would be the sun.
Hacienda Heights. Our first guest, as I mentioned at the beginning of the show, is a friend of Marty's Corner and a personal friend of mine. I've probably known this lady for maybe 10 years. I'm thinking maybe 10, 12 years. Again, all of you know her for years. She was the host of the very popular children's show Romper Room, a living legend in Southern California. Can you please give a warm to our good friend, Marianne King. Marianne, come on out, sweetheart. Give me a good to see you, sweetheart.
Have a seat right here, sweetheart. Have a seat.
Welcome back to the corner.
Oh, it's, you know, this is like a old home week.
I appreciate that.
I love coming here. And, oh, Marty, we've known each other forever. You've grown up on this show, you know?
Probably. Maybe the beard has grown, maybe.
I love the beard. You could just put it white and be Santa.
I probably could. Yeah, I probably could. I probably could. I need to get out and work out some more.
And I loved your Christmas tree.
Oh, do you like that?
Is it decorated?
It is already, yes. I got it up and it's decorated. It's beautiful. Do you have a tree in your home?
Oh, of course.
A live one, or do you have
one?
No,
I have one.
You have the plastic ones, do you really?
Well, you know, it's very unique because it's a leopard Christmas tree. I love the jungle look.
Do you really have a leopard Christmas tree?
It goes in my jungle room. You've been there.
Yes,
right. Shoot there?
Sure.
Yeah.
That's incredible. So, the Christmas time, what do you have going? I know you're involved in the community. You have all these different organizations.
Oh,
you're
yes.
doing things. In fact, I called you and I on the phone. You had a dinner party going on, which
yes,
I'm sorry I interrupted you.
No, you didn't. That's fine. It's just that I had a house full of people.
So, what is on your agenda for the holiday season? What kind of things are you doing?
You know what? Everything started the very first day of December. It's just been frantic. Sometimes two and three things every day.
Is that right?
Yeah, and then the big city of industry had their Christmas deal last night, and there were about 200, 300 people there. So that was delightful.
You're involved in a lot of different groups.
A lot of things.
Just name off a couple of organizations and groups that you're a part of.
Well, the rodeo.
Right, the professional rodeo.
And the concerts in the park.
Concerts in the park.
And I'm politically involved with, I'm president of the Republican Women for Pointy Hills.
Right.
That keeps me busy. And then we have a bridge foundation at ROP that we raise money for scholarships and Rotary and, oh gosh, the list goes on.
Along with doing your day job.
That's right.
You know, so you're a busy person.
But you know what? Everything I do creates an arena for a different group of people. So it broadens all my horizons. I meet so many wonderful people. And you know, the rodeo is so much fun because they gave me the best job of all. They asked me to be on the rodeo committee. I said, okay, what do you want me to do? Well, we want you to be the hospitality person. Okay, what do? You pack 300 goodie bags. It's a three-day event, you know, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday.
Right.
And you give one to every cowboy and cowgirl. Now, what better job could you have?
That's
I've never
alley.
Seen so many beautiful belt buckles in my life. Because these cowboys all wear these gorgeous belt buckles, and you can't help but notice them. And I say, wow, you were the champion calf rope, or you were the champion brock. And they wear their trophies on their belts.
Is that right?
The buckles.
Well, you're from Oklahoma. That's right up your alley.
Oh, yeah. I'm an Okie, yeah.
You're an Okie from way back. Does it snow in Oklahoma?
Oh, my gosh.
Does it really?
Yes, and the wind blows, and it gets cold, and then it rains, and then it hails, and then it sleets, and Oh my gosh, I went to a football game because I go back for the Sooner football games. And it started out raining, and we all sit there in the rain, and then pretty soon it's sleeting, and then pretty soon it's snowing, and nobody leaves.
Just hunker down,
you
huh?
You betcha.
You're used to the weather over there, I guess.
Yeah. You have to.
Along with the many different groups and organizations you belong to, at one time you actually were a member of the board here at Channel 3.
Absolutely, for 5 years.
For 5 years. And I said, you heard my monologue
a little bit about the station.
Mm-hmm. What's your feeling about that? I mean, how important is this station to the community?
Oh, my gosh.
And the people that support it?
Marty, I don't know what we would do without the station. Because the rodeo alone is a three-day event, and the Tim Keeler is always there with the truck and
right.
a huge crew. It's a wonderful, wonderful community event. And then that is replayed, so everybody gets an opportunity to enjoy the thrills and the spills and the excitement of the rodeo. It's just wonderful. Now, if we didn't have that, I mean, if you weren't there that day, it's gone.
Yeah.
And then the concerts in the park.
Right, exactly.
My goodness. We've been doing concerts in the park. We're going into our 12th year.
Is that right?
Yes, and that's in the summer every Tuesday. And we get to enjoy that via the television.
And then the July 4th parade, which is like 18, 19 years.
And you know what? You and I did that together this year.
Right.
Wasn't that fun?
That was a blast.
God,
that was a blast.
I love parades.
That was a blast.
And you know, it gets bigger every year. We had, 3,000 to 4,000
people lining the streets.
But if you weren't one of those people lining the street, you didn't get to see all of that wonderful stuff that went down the street.
Do you think this station has a lot of support in the community? I mean,
oh, yes.
Do you really?
You mean what?
A lot of support in the community. I mean, people are watching it. People
are
very much in tune to this station and see it as an important part of the community.
And plus all your other programming, because I watch your other programming, too.
Right.
And who doesn't watch Marty's Corner?
Well.
And then you see all of your other talent. But it's just good to have it here.
Yeah.
You're going to showcase talent tonight.
Right.
Where would we see it if we didn't see it on your show?
That was the other thing. You have a lot of groups and organizations and individuals that have an opportunity to get their voice out and get their, go ahead and tell about their organization and trying
to
help people and support people.
And promote it. And if they want to, and they didn't know that, they could just call the station and say, hey, could you talk about the historical club, because the historical society is all about the history of this valley. How many of us know about the history of the San Gabriel Valley?
Right.
And all the things that go on there. For just an example.
It is a great facility. I've seen and been to a lot of facilities here in the San Gabriel Valley. This is probably the best run, the most professional.
It is.
And you can tell by being here and looking at the programming commanders is a great great thing. We are asking for support of the community and helping us keep this station, and we want to know if you're on board with us.
Oh, Marty.
I'm just asking because,
you want me to go knock on doors?
No, I don't want you to do that.
We should go with a megahorn and say, come on, listen up. How many years have we been doing this?
I love this
station.
Over 20 years the station's been
up.
We're going to ask you to make little goodie bags to take with you from door to door.
Okay.
And maybe, can you do that for us?
And I remember when we did the 10th anniversary celebration at your house.
Yes, impromptu.
Yes.
If I remember correctly,
it was fun. Just fun things.
It is. It is a good vehicle for it. And also, if you're watching TV, you can do your own show down here.
You can. And I tell everybody that. You want to do your show? Go down, because they have a volunteer, wonderful crew. My gosh.
Yes.
They're great. And you can do that. And it's the only access television station I know of that's really on top of everything.
That's actually doing things for the community.
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah. Do you make a lot of food during the holidays? Do you cook a lot? Do you do the cookies? Do you do the pastries? Or?
Well, I have two grandchildren now. They're 6 and 8, and boy, do they like to make cookies. Oh, yes.
We have a guest on. I think we're kind of hungry, and we're excited about this. This gentleman, as I mentioned at the beginning of the show, is a comedian, a stand-up comedian first and foremost.
Ah.
But for years, he hosted his own food show called Food Rules on the public access station. And he's been on with us before, and of course, he's been nice enough to come back, and he's going to make some holiday treats for us. And I know that we're
all day.
And maybe people in the audience might be able to sample some of these too. We'll see how that goes. Can you please give
him I look at, what's his name, Tom?
Tom.
Well, I'm going to have to see Tom in the magic mirror.
Okay, one more
time. Now, I've got a magic mirror. You all know that.
Yes.
And it's really magic.
It is?
Yeah.
Okay. Can you please give a warm welcome to Tom Riehl? Tom, come on out, Tom.
What are you asking about here, man? Tom. This is Marianne. Tom.
Hello.
Have a seat, Mr. Riehl. A pleasure always. Have a seat.
How you doing?
I'm doing
I just want to hear her say, I see Tommy.
I can do it. Oh. Romper bumper, stomper boo. See?
That's what the
tell
trip
me,
up here.
Tell me, tell me, do. Magic mirror, tell me today. Did all my friends have fun at play? Are we going to have
I
fun at play?
I see. I need one of those mirrors.
Isn't that cool?
And I see you. All grown up, many of you.
See? You're a good doobie.
I'm a good doobie.
That's right.
A doobie-doo.
A doobie-doo.
That's right.
Do you know what a good doobie is?
No, I don't.
Oh, my.
I grew up on the East Coast.
Oh, dear.
So, but we had Romper Room, but we didn't have, we had someone else.
Different host.
Different host, but the same Romper
Room. Two major markets, New York,
and Philly. Yeah.
Well, you cornered one of them for sure.
Yeah.
I said, along with being a stand-up comedian, you did an incredible food show for years and years. How many years were you on Public Access?
I think like 9 years.
9 years?
Yeah.
And not anymore, though.
No, we threw the talent about a year and a half ago. It was a lot of work, as you know.
Yeah, sure it was.
And how often were you on, Tom?
I'm sorry?
Every day or once a
no,
week?
No, we were on once a week.
That
we,
is
we
a
did
lot
a
of
show.
Work.
We did a show once. We taped once a month. We did like four shows on the weekend, and
wow.
then that was our month's worth of shows for the
an
month.
An hour long?
That was a half an hour
half
long.
Half an hour?
Yeah. But it was a difficult, a long process, you know, and to do it month after mm-hmm. month, year after year, it really... It gives you gray hair.
That's yeah. what happens.
I'm only 22.
Are you?
Yeah.
That's what happens to you, you know?
Yeah.
I know, I'm only 12. Yeah. I know the feeling. I'm a husky 12.
Yeah.
I love that word, husky. But you're no longer doing it now. But again, we've asked you to come on and do something special that, again, you've been on before. You've made donuts here on the show.
We made donuts, yes.
And you brought something very special for the holiday season.
Well, this isn't really, you kind of overbuild it. It's not really true.
I lied.
Actually, what this is, it's, you know, we always try to, on our show, always cook things that guys could make. Things would be easy for guys or people who weren't really good at cooking, right?
Right.
So being it's the holiday season, we thought we'd make some homemade hot chocolate. You know,
oh,
from
nice.
Scratch, and homemade marshmallows to go into hot chocolate.
You're
kidding. But what's nice about it is you can give this as a gift too, which you'll see, you know, when we're all done. So it's very simple to do. We can do it in probably 2 seconds.
What do you want? What do you want me to hand over?
Bring
first?
It all over here. Bring that. Okay. If you bring that whole cutting board, we'll sit it right
okay,
here.
Okay, we're gonna go ahead and.
And how about if I kind of we'll work together and you can kind of
sure.
mix it up,
and
you know, because I know you like getting involved in the whole cooking process.
I try to anyhow.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm going to bring all this stuff over. I'm going to put this. I don't know where you want this darn thing.
Is that hot water there?
I don't know what that is. You brought it over. And you got like, well, you...
That might be hot water.
Okay, and you also have like a bowls and mixing
bowls,
things.
Yeah, this is all stuff that you have in your kitchen. It's all real simple stuff here. And there's not really a lot of ingredients. And I got 3 cups here, Mary. Maybe you want to have one.
Okay, sure.
Marty, there's one for you.
All right.
And as you'll see, there's not really much in it.
I don't have enough hands.
Okay.
I'm going to move my water out of the way.
So here's what we're going to do. It's just a few ingredients here, and we'll just walk you through it.
All right.
And this is something anyone can do, and it's great for the holidays, hot chocolate. Okay, we're going to start off with some powdered milk. Okay, these are all household ingredients. We've got powdered milk.
It sure is.
Yeah.
It's snowing. Okay.
Powdered milk, we're going to do 3/4 cup.
Okay.
Why don't you take, and this is another good trick I've learned. If you have measuring cups that you can't find them all in your drawer,
right,
if you take one of those little nylon ties, just run it through
true.
And throw it in there. They're all there at the same time.
Right there.
You can do it with your spoons and your teaspoons,
good
too.
Idea.
You're smart, huh?
Ingenious.
It's a genius. Okay, so why don't you hold that one?
All right.
We'll get 3/4. Marty's very easily entertained.
I am.
Okay, so this is powdered milk here. So we'll go about 3/4 cup. So if you just kind of throw that in there like
mm-hmm.
that. Yeah, right in there.
Oof.
Okay. And now we're going to have 3/4 cup of sugar.
Okay.
Just regular granulated sugar, like that. That's about 3/4 cup, like that.
Put it in also?
Yes.
All right.
Then we're going to do about a half a cup. Oh, my God, I forgot the cocoa powder. Oh, no. Is the cocoa powder over there?
Oh, I'm sorry. Thank you so much.
You know, no, that's not it, though. But I think I forgot the cocoa powder.
What is this?
What's in the sack?
That's powdered sugar. I forgot the cocoa powder.
Does anyone know?
This is going to be interesting.
Well, you forgot it at home, or
I forgot it at home. I had it sitting out. I must not have thrown it in my.
So, is there a plan B?
hot cocoa without cocoa.
Okay,
let's try it.
But you know what? No.
Just go ahead.
No, we can fake it. Here, I'll tell you what we're going to do here.
All right, fine. Go for it.
See, this is something I made up earlier.
We're live, ladies and gentlemen.
And this has a lot of cocoa in here.
I'm sure it does.
And it looks like cocoa. So just go ahead and throw that.
Okay,
in there like
fine.
That.
We're okay, playing.
Gonna be,
go ahead, just in here.
Oh, in fact, man. It calls around. Let's go for a full one.
Okay, sure. Let's
woo.
Okay, a double shot. Okay.
Wow. So you can always improvise in the kitchen,
as
right?
As you can tell.
Okay. So we're going to mix that up like that.
Okay.
Okay, very simple. Now we got the most important ingredient here next to the cocoa.
Yeah.
Is the bittersweet chocolate.
All right. There
you
we
like
go.
That, right?
Now we're talking. Now,
yeah, you like that.
I like that. Okay.
So all we want to do with that is we want to
You can buy it in the store, just throw it on the cutting board here, and what you want to do is you want to chop it up in pieces.
Because you got a knife. I know. I still am.
The host of Romper Room with a blade.
Sick Christmas show here at Marty's Corner. Sick Christmas show.
All right.
Okay, thank you very much.
Okay, I'm just going to stand over here because I'm not good with sharp objects.
You want to kind of just chop it up in some relatively small pieces.
All right. I'm going to kind of lean back here as you're... Have you ever cut yourself accidentally?
Oh, lots of times. Lots of times.
Yep.
But you know what? With one of these knives here, when you go down your finger like that, and it goes through it, and it's a mess.
Yeah, I'm sure it would be.
Just gives it a little color.
Yeah. So, but you know what? You can run it through the food processor, but you want to keep the pieces pretty good size, right?
Yeah.
Now we're going to just throw those right in the bowl.
All right.
And if there's aluminum foil, you don't want that in there.
No, no.
So we'll just throw that in a bowl like that, and that's all there is to it. Okay? Mm-hmm. So we mix that up. Mix that up. Now that looks good, right?
Oh yeah,
I mean
delicious,
that's good stuff there. Now imagine how good that would look if you actually had cocoa in it.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, so what you want to do is you got the measuring cups here?
Oh sure, no problem.
You're gonna take like about a half, get one of the little half daubers there.
Well, I don't know what a half one is.
See, that's
okay,
the
one. Half on it. Okay.
Yeah, one, and then a little line and a two under. Yeah.
That's a metric system.
So we're gonna take one of those like that. Uh-huh. We're gonna get about a half a cup. We're gonna put that in there like that. Uh-huh. Okay. Marianne, we'll get
it. Looks like sand, Tom.
It kind of looks like sand. That's the powdered milk. I'm going to put a little in there like that. That's yours.
Oh.
And then if you hand me that cup over there.
Sure, no problem.
Okay. Put there like that. And now we have the hot water. Like that. And that's all you do is you add the hot water. Hopefully your crew heated this up. We might have cold cocoa.
Oh, great.
With no cocoa.
This is going to be interesting.
Oh, look at that. It's piping hot.
Oh, that's good.
Like that. And we'll get a... I have a spoon in there too.
Whoa!
Warm my hands on
there. You want to stir it up real good.
Smells great, like Tom. That.
Now, who the hell are you?
Is this Tony?
If I wasn't, I would brought an extra cup. Yeah, the guy walks in.
Tony the Nazi.
That's Tony.
Okay, like that. Tony, now it might not be as chocolatey because obviously we don't have cocoa.
You stir that in there.
But here's the kicker of the whole thing here.
Sure, there's a kicker.
This is homemade marshmallows here, which I did because we didn't really have the time, so I made these up ahead of time.
Okay, great.
I didn't know anyone did either.
You make homemade marshmallows.
I amaze myself sometimes, Marianne.
All right.
Wow.
But anyway, basically it's like gelatin and convection sugar and egg whites. Now watch this here. If we can clear this deck off here. I don't know how much time I have here. I'm kind of speeding through things here. But
a spoon to stir yours up with there.
Thank you.
Milky on time, Tony?
Oh, we got plenty of time.
Okay, fine.
Now watch this one, Marty.
What are you going to do?
Hold your cup there so I don't hit it.
Okay.
There you go. Put that over like that.
Oh, that looks bad.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, it does look bad, doesn't it?
I think it looks interesting.
Yeah. But what?
Wow.
Hey, I never said the food was good, but it's always fun.
Fine. Go ahead.
No, watch. But look at that.
Look at that.
Now imagine that without the yellow film on top.
Okay, sure.
Now watch. I don't know. You know, quite
what
honestly,
is the yellow film?
I don't know. I know. Oh. Wait, we'll cut the yellow film off. It's kind of like beef. You know, you cut the fat off like that. Now what? No, but watch. Look, Marty. Check it out.
Well, what is that?
It looks like Hollywood snow.
Well, now watch. We're gonna throw this in here like this.
Oh.
Remember how we shook it?
Okay. Sure. Yeah. He's putting a white substance into a bag.
Check it out.
Okay. He put a white substance into a baggie.
Okay.
Oh, it's powdered sugar.
Yeah, it's powdered sugar.
Just go and give
him.
You
got a marshmallow right now, like.
Wow. Oh, that is so neat.
That's all there is to it.
And we can drink this.
yeah.
Well, you have your ground cinnamon. Does that go on top?
Oh, we didn't put the cinnamon in either.
Well, where do we put the cinnamon?
Go ahead, give me some cinnamon. I don't care.
Sprinkle it on top.
Yeah, we can put a little on top there.
Yeah.
Oh, hold on.
That's okay. I taste good,
too.
Wow.
I see cinnamon. You want some cinnamon?
Yeah.
And cinnamon is good for you, you know.
That's chocolatey?
It's good, actually. Really good.
Is it?
Yeah.
Is it not real chocolatey?
No, though? It's good. Take a sip.
It's delicious. It's delicious.
Yeah, it is good news.
That's great.
And it's homemade.
And it's homemade.
And this takes all of like, what, 5 minutes?
It's too bad Tom didn't bring any more cups.
Yeah.
But you know what? It's this jelly stuff on the bottom of this really bothers me. I don't know what the hell that is.
What is it?
I don't know. I mean, I only put egg and...
It looks like a mucus of some kind or something. I don't...
It looks like it should be in a test tube. It's just a mason jar or something.
Well, Tom, we're so glad you came down and messed up this hot chocolate and marshmallow
for us.
Now, again...
This is really great.
It's really good.
Very, very delicious.
Along with the stand-up, you got any gigs you got coming up?
Actually, we do. I'm gonna be at the Irvine Improv on Tuesday, and then we got a big New Year's Eve show down at the Orange County Performing Arts Center on December 31st.
Are you gonna be cooking it all?
No, we're gonna be doing stand-up comedy.
Thank God.
Yeah. Thank God. Yeah. Stick to the comedy.
Yeah.
We here for Tom Riehl one time, baby. Tom Riehl.
Well, way up north where the air gets cold, there's a tale about Christmas that you've all been told. And a real famous cat all dressed up in red, and he spends the whole year working up.
We're back live here on Marty's Corner getting helpful tips from Tom how to make chocolate milk without chocolate.
But it was so good.
It was good though. It really was good.
I don't think he needs the cocoa.
I don't think so.
I think cocoa's overrated.
I think it is too.
I think the cinnamon did really well.
Yeah.
In keeping with the festive feeling here on Marty's Corner, we have a young lady, as I mentioned, again, an incredible musician. She studies for 4 years over in England, and she's back now, back in the States.
and she's going to be performing some Christmas songs for us. Can you please give a warm welcome to Tabitha Greenlees? Tabitha!
Take it away, Tabitha.
Ooh.
Stay right there. Stay right there. I'm going to get over here. I'm going to get over here. First of all, can we introduce your accompanist tonight?
This is my mother, Judy.
Judy, right here.
Thank you, Judy.
Real quick, one of the most interesting stories you told me is that your, I guess, the headmaster at your school was Prince Charles.
That's correct.
And you met Prince Charles. What's he like?
He's much shorter than you anticipate. But he's very lovely. He's absolutely lovely. And he's quite soft-spoken and very posh. And he was just such a lovely gentleman to meet. He asked me about what instrument I played, because I was part of a fanfare ensemble that had to play for Prince Charles when he arrived. And we had to play God Save the Queen. I thought that...
That's great!
I thought that I'd have to, you know, appear before an American Activities Board.
Why? Did you mess up or something? Is that what happened?
No, just because, you know, I thought it'd be like high treason or something. Okay. But
have one of the colonials out there.
Yeah, something like that. But it was very good.
Now you're saying you have to walk backwards and you can't shake his hand.
Yes, you're not allowed to address His Royal Highness unless he addresses you first. And you can only take his hand if it's been offered to you. And so fortunately, when I was formally introduced to him, he graciously acknowledged me and handed me his hand. So I've actually shook.
I think shook. It's shook, yes. You're an American now.
There, I've yeah. shook. I've shook I don't Prince think Charles's England, hand, but. Yeah.
What do you plan to do now that you're back in the States?
Well, my plan is to hopefully move to Massachusetts in the next couple of months and to start an expansion of the nonprofit that my mom started here in Hacienda Heights.
Artistic Journeys,
that's right. Correct. We're hoping to start a brand new expansion of it in the state of Massachusetts. So hopefully I'll be in charge of that.
Well, we wish you all the best, and welcome back to the States. Can we hit one more time again for Tabitha Greenlee? Outstanding. We need to go away for a 3-minute break. We'll be right back. Don't go away.
Those were the days, my friend. We thought they'd never end. Sing and dance forever and a day. Live the life.
Welcome back to Marty's Corner Live Saturday Night. We have a group of musicians that have come down to perform to us tonight, and we're running short on time, so you want to make sure we have a chance to listen to them. Can you please give a warm welcome to the Truly Lover Trio?
I wonder why you threw your diary away. When you walk by, I nearly die. Why can't I say? Yeah, things were fine, you were mine just yesterday. Now we're apart. Breaking up is breaking my heart. I find myself alone at night, and then I cry. No tenderness, my happiness, just say goodbye. Yeah. Now you're gone, I'm alone, I wonder why we had to fight. Yeah, baby, breaking up is breaking my heart, baby. Breaking up is breaking my heart. Here we go, here we go. The love affair we used to share is gold and steel. I love you and I love you.
gentlemen. Marcel, of course, the Truly Lover Trio. What kind of gigs you got coming up? What are you guys got playing? What are you doing?
What am I doing right now?
What are you doing right now? I don't care. I don't
know. Well,
I've been drinking hot chocolate without chocolate.
Well, how is that? That looks pretty good.
I'm all wiped out. I got too much cinnamon in me or something.
So what was it? Lemonade? No.
I don't know what. It has some kind of a lactose.
Cinnamon with a...
With a gel.
That's good.
It's good for the hair.
My uncle needs to try that.
I can tell. Yeah, good job.
Yeah.
What do you have coming up as far as gigs?
We going up to... Oh.
Take a shot. Take a shot.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah, I told you. Yeah, not bad, not bad.
Good.
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah.
Good.
It's good stuff.
We're going up to San Francisco next month. We just came back from Cleveland. We played at the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.
Oh, great.
For a Roy Orbison thing. And yeah, you like Roy Orbison? Yeah, this is one of your biggest fans here.
Is that right?
Yeah. Right?
Yeah.
So, yeah, everything's good. We're going up to San Francisco. We toured New York, so we have a new record out. So.
Yeah, and what's your website if you want to get a hold of you? What's the best way, Marcel?
Let's see. TrulyLoverTrio.com.
Right.
And we're also on something called MySpace. You know, it's a big thing.
Oh, yeah, big thing. You're going to be doing another song for us. What song are you going to be doing for us right now?
We're going to do, what's it called? We're going to do one for the... Pretending from the record, off
right.
The record.
One more time, ladies and gentlemen, the Truly Lover Trio, guys, take it away!
Even if I ask you, you'll never tell. No, deep in your heart, you'll keep it with. I look very good. Oh, I'm just a fool. Try to hide my food. Pretending I'm forgetting you.
Marianne King for Romper Room. Marianne, thank you, sweetheart.
You are so welcome.
Tom Riehl is hot cocoa. Again, Merry Christmas, Happy New Year. Take care. The Truly Lover. We're going to play one more song. We'll see you next month on Marty's Corner. Take care, guys. Get us away. Let's go. One more time.
Have a blue Christmas without you. Have a so blue. Just thinking about you.
Christmas without you. I'll be so blue just thinking about you. You'll be doing all right with your Christmas white. I have a blue, blue.